back in the last decade, when Warcraft 3 maps were picking up popularity despite of the ever-increasing player base of Dota that was stealing the spotlight, there were a few mods out there that were able to escape the shadows and get their limelight. The Hunter vs. Hunted became a really popular subgenre, but there weren't too many of them out there. One of those, which held up for a pretty long time, was Dark Deeds. I'm Stormy, with the capital Z, and today we shall be taking a dip into the nostalgic memories of Warcraft 3 maps and talking about Dark Deeds by Weevilman. Dark Deeds is a Hunter vs. Hunted map which is pretty easy to learn and not too difficult to master. It's super fun to play with friends and strangers and has aspects that you do not find in the other maps of this particular genre. Now, normally in the Hunter vs. Hunted game, it is pre-decided for who plays the Hunter and who plays the Hunted. But the special thing about this map is that nobody knows who is going to be the Hunter. All the players start off as a farmer in the center of the map, and each of them has to run a distance and make their own settlement. While everyone is allied to each other, you do not have shared vision, which is essentially what makes the map interesting. During the first night, one of the players is randomly selected by the game to turn into the Evil One. The objective of the Evil One is to kill the other players, while the objective of the other players is simple enough to kill the Evil One. But first, the players need to find out who is the Evil One to begin with. The Evil One can cause destruction during the nighttime and sneakily return to his base during the day and pretend that nothing happened, as he reverts back to the old farmer form that everyone else is playing. The Evil One is also randomized by the game to turn into either Dracula or a Witch Doctor or the Grim Reaper or the High Cultist or a Pit Lord. Each evil hero has a different set of abilities, characteristics, and playstyles, which makes each matchup slightly different than the other. Like any other hunter, the evil can easily overpower and kill the hunted. The mod slightly blends into the altered melee genre if you have a brief look at how the tech tree progresses for the farmers. It's pretty simple, does not throw too many things at you at once, clearly indicates the buildings that you need to build first, and unlocks higher tech level buildings slowly as you progress. The fun part of the game for the hunted is that your army is essentially the farmer's family. You first get a wife, then the children grow up into adults and can be upgraded into different unit classes, and there is no way to control the gender, so you never know what kind of army you're going to end up with. As a farmer, you also have the option to just kill the other farmers if you're tired of trying to locate the evil guy, or you just don't care and want to be a bully. There's also an NPC town guard who patrols the map looking for the evil guy and adds a little threat to the overpowered hunter. The game is all about deception, whether it be through in-game chat or actions that will make a player suspicious of being the evil one. It definitely urges you to chat with the other guys while playing and have a good time while trying to figure out who is the evil one, which in turn creates friendship and everlasting bonds on Battle.net. As per the modding community, the last known and official version of the map by the maker Weevilman is Dark Deeds 6, but there are more versions out there by unknown editors, which friends of the maker say that he did not make and are rumored to be unofficially ripped. It's least likely that we will be getting any update on the map by the original maker. The mod was popular enough to land itself into StarCraft II's arcade. While the map has some known issues, it's definitely worth giving a try with your homies on a weekend night of Warcraft 3. What's your opinion on the map? Let me know in the comments below, and for more Warcraft 3 content, subscribe to my channel and tune in every Thursday for a video on modding. That's it for this video. Do make sure to hit the like button and share this with your friends. If you want your mod to be featured on my show, send me a PM with link to your map mod and description about it. I'll definitely have a look at it and let you know. If you're finding difficulty in finding players for playing Dark Deeds, you can join my Discord channel. I'm linking that in the description below as well. Well, that's it. That's all for this video. Hope to see you guys in the next one. Z out. Bye-bye.